You're watching Dormet Dining. I'm your host, Nicole Cormier. Here with me today is Ismaris, a BSU student.
Hi.
How are you?
Good.
Are you ready to make a complete meal with me today?
Yep.
Okay. We're gonna cook this meal right in your microwave, and it's a spaghetti squash primavera. So it's a very excellent source or replacement for any pasta dish. So this is what a spaghetti squash looks like. It's kind of like a big yellow football. And all we're gonna do is cook it in the microwave. We're gonna poke four holes in it, one, two on this side, flip it over, two on this side, and we're gonna stick it in a microwave safe dish and microwave it for 14 minutes. So you can cook a spaghetti squash in the oven as well, but it does cook very nicely in the microwave. Sounds good?
Okay.
I like to choose like a smaller knife to cut the holes in it just because it is a little tough. You have to use your muscles and just be very careful with the knife. Okay. There's our fourth hole. And we're just gonna take the sticker off of it because we are going to place it in the microwave. Oh. All right, would you like to put that in the microwave for us? 14 minutes. Okay, our spaghetti squash is done. The bowl is gonna be very hot, so you do want to use either mittens or towels to remove it. And the squash itself is going to be very hot as well. So we just wanna take it and place it on either a cutting board. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna slice it all the way around, just like we did from the avocado. Inside is going to be some seeds that need to be removed, so we'll remove those, but you do wanna be careful. Typically, you wanna put this to the side and let it cool or inside the refrigerator so you don't burn your hands. I'm just gonna use a towel to hold it in place. And you'll want to use a slightly larger knife so you can cut all the way through the entire squash. So we'll start here. In order to test, because every microwave is different, some microwaves might take longer than 14 minutes. So in order to see if your spaghetti squash is done, what you want to do is be able to push and indent. See how that's indenting there? And just be careful. Some of it will be a little bit soft, but as long as there's certain places where it doesn't indent, you'll be good. All right, so we're gonna go ahead and cut this in half. Okay, and we have the inside of our spaghetti squash, and what you'll notice is that it's actually going to be forked out and it will look very similar to spaghetti. So we do want to take the seeds out, so it's just in the very center. So in a separate bowl, you'll just want to scoop the seeds out either with a fork or a spoon, whatever you have most readily available. You can make any of your favorite pasta dishes. You can replace the pasta with actual spaghetti squash if you'd like to. But we're gonna do a pasta primavera with the spaghetti squash today. Some steam get in you. Ismaris, what's your major?
Communications.
Communications? Do you have a busy class schedule?
Not really.
Not really? Do you ever cook in your dorm? Sure, putting anytime that you're putting any meals together, that is food preparation, so we will consider that. So perhaps you'll want to try this recipe in your dorm room if you're in between classes, or the best thing about it is we're going to start scooping the spaghetti squash out, and after we make one big dish of it, we can actually put it in individual containers, so you can have three different lunches stacked up in your refrigerator, ready to go to take to classes.
And for how long would it stay good in the fridge?
This would stay good for 4 to 7 days. Okay, so we'll put our seeds to the side and in a bowl. Again, be careful. You want to make sure that you let it cool, or I'm going to use a towel today. We're going to take our fork and simply just start scraping it out. And it's going to just pop right out just like spaghetti. Okay, so we have our spaghetti squash all cooked, ready to go. And we're gonna add some pasta sauce and some vegetables. So whatever vegetables you choose to use, any frozen vegetables will do. This is the steam ready California blend with broccoli, cauliflower, and carrots. Put this to the side. And open your jar of any type of pasta sauce. This is a marinara sauce that I chose for today, but you can use any. Let me test my muscles. Okay. And now that we have that off, we're just gonna do about a half a cup. You can always add more or less, and we'll take a spoon and just mix it up here.
Sounds good.
Move it a little closer, stir it up for me. Do you think that's enough sauce, or would you like to add some more?
A little more.
Okay. We'll take out our vegetables and just open the bag. And sometimes frozen vegetables can be a little watery, so I like to gently open the bag and make sure that not all of the water goes into our dish. Flying broccoli. There we go. Okay. And we can, another cauliflower. Just mix this up. And you could add a little bit of Parmesan cheese if you wanted to. But this is basically our spaghetti primavera, spaghetti squash primavera. Very colorful. So we have three different types of vegetables here. Actually, four different types of vegetables because our spaghetti squash. We're gonna do a little taste test and see if you can tell the difference between spaghetti squash and pasta. So this is it's a vegetarian meal, but the interesting is all vegetables. So when we have, you can make two different meals with it, but the leftovers this is a great recipe because it makes so much, and if you put it into individual containers, you can have yourself two additional meals. So we'll go ahead and do that. It will stay in your fridge up to 7 days. Okay, so there we go. Put the covers on in the fridge, and you have two extra lunches or dinners for yourself. All right. Yum.
It's actually better than pasta.
What? Well, thank you for watching Dormet Dining.